And what a wonderful time this is. You are living in a wonderful time. I'm very impressed. Do you know, you won't believe this, in my time, if you based your entire career on unverifiable and sketchy claims and you refused to pay your taxes, you would be chased into the sea. Hounded out of every civilized nation on earth. I should know, it happened to me. But I think if I'd been born a little bit later, I could have been president of the United States. And maybe I will be. What a wonderful time. This is a golden age of what some people might call bullshit. But wait a minute. I don't like that word. Let's talk just a moment before we get it any further. Let's talk about facts and truth. Because I have a very nuanced and, in my opinion, very advanced view of truth. Let me tell you a quick story. 1923, I was riding a train that I had built with my own hands. And I met a guy named Snake Thompson. He was a spy. And he took me under his wing. And one night, Snake was getting real drunk on the train, because why not? And he said, "Ron, listen to me. In this life, if something isn't true for you, it isn't true." Wow, what a great piece of advice that is. Sure, we define our own reality. Of course we do. But I think that the inverse of that must also be correct. If something is true for you, then it is true. If I tell you something and you believe it, then it's true for you. And it doesn't matter if anybody else in the world believes it, including me. If I tell you that I can move objects with my mind and you believe it, well, maybe I know I can't move objects with my mind because I've tried and I can't do it. But if you believe it, well, who am I to tell you it's not true? And if you're inspired to open your checkbook and pay me to tell you wild things, you know, great. And I just feel like today is a glorious time for people believing things that a charismatic leader tells them. This should be a great time for Scientology. But unfortunately, the organization seems a little bit on the ropes. We've got people dropping out and making nasty documentaries and mean TV shows. That's not nice. That Paul Haggis guy, that's not nice. You know, I have now seen Battlefield Earth, and I know it didn't turn out great, but it's better than Crash. Fuck that Paul Haggis guy. He's not a nice guy. And Leah Remini, she's mean. You know what we're going to do? You know what we're going to do to Leah Remini? Because I'll tell you, in my day, if somebody said something nasty about Scientology, we would destroy their lives. It was one of the funnest things we ever did. We'd call all your neighbors and tell them you're a prostitute. You know, get your fingerprint on a piece of paper and write a threatening letter to the president on there. Have somebody show up at your door and stab you. Just goofy pranks. And it worked. People really thought twice about saying nasty things about Scientology. So we're going to do it again. We're going to break into Leah Remini's house, and we're going to replace all of her shoes with identical shoes, a half size smaller. And then a couple of months, we're going to do it again and again and again until she jumps off a building. And then Haggis, we're going to go into his house and we're going to squeeze all the toothpaste out of his toothpaste and we're going to fill it with a totally different brand of toothpaste. And then stab him. That's going to be great.